Good morning, everybody. We are in Luke chapter 5, verse 1 in our devos this morning. Luke writes, "On one occasion, while the crowd was pressing in on Jesus to hear the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret, and he saw two boats by the lake, but the fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, which was Simon's, that would be Peter, he asked him to put out a little from the land, and he sat down and he taught the people from the boat. And when he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, 'Put out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch.' And Simon answered, 'Master, we toiled all night and took nothing, but at your word, I will let down the nets.' And when they had done this, they enclosed a large number of fish, and their nets were breaking. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them, and they came and filled both the boats so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, 'Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord.' For he and all who were with him were astonished at the catch of fish that they had taken. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, 'Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching men.' And when they had brought their boats to land, they left everything and followed him." I love this miracle, this story of Jesus calling Peter, James, and John. And what's really interesting is that Jesus uses a boat as a pulpit, knowing he's going to call fishermen to be his disciples. It's not lost on me that the creativity of Jesus to use what they know in order to connect with them and their hearts. And then this carpenter, Jesus, tells Simon, this professional fisherman, in the middle of the day, "Hey, let's go out to the deep and catch some fish." And you got to be imagining Peter's like, "Jesus, you might want to stick with woodworking, because I know this thing about fishing, and this is not the right time. You stick to preaching. Let me worry about the fishing." And I think we all do that in our lives. I know I do that in my life, where I'm like, "Jesus, I'll let you in on the spiritual side of my life, but everything else I'll take care of. I've got it." And Jesus wants to impact our everyday. He wants to impact our going in and our coming out, our work, our family, our relationships, our everything, and our fishing and our sleeping, right? And the Bible says, Jesus said, "Seek first the kingdom of heaven, and all these other things will be given to you." He teaches us to pray, "Your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven." Jesus, manifest your presence in this moment in my everyday life. And Jesus wants to take us into the deep. He wants us to experience something fresh and new that maybe we've never experienced before. And often, as you read through the miracles of Jesus, when Jesus reveals himself in like new ways, he often tells people, "Don't be afraid." You know, like when he's about to raise a dead girl, he says it. When he walks on the water, he says it. At his transfiguration, he says it. Well, when he was raised from the dead, he says it. And he says it again here. He says, "Do not be afraid." And the reason he says that is because oftentimes following Jesus into the deep will cause fear in our lives, because we know it's risky. Because we know that he's going to do something that maybe we're uncomfortable with. Or maybe it's unpopular, or maybe it even seems a bit silly. He will ask us to follow him. And wherever he goes, that's where we should be. I encourage you today to follow Jesus wherever he leads you, out into the deep, into the waters that maybe of the unfamiliar or the unknown, to lean into Jesus as you do that. God bless you guys. Have an awesome day.